Hello everyone, welcome back to part 13 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. In today's tutorial, we will add a main menu and loading screen to our game. Before we begin, if you want to download the UI textures I used in this video, you can find the download link in the video description. Let's get started. In Unreal Engine, go to the content browser, navigate to the textures folder, and right-click to create a new folder called UI. Import the images you want to use for the main menu and loading screen. Next, create a new level in the maps folder, name it main menu, duplicate this level twice, and name the duplicates loading screen underscore mm to gm and loading screen underscore gm to mm. Save these levels. Now, in the HUD folder, right-click to create a new widget blueprint and name it main menu underscore UI. Open it, and from the palette tab, add a canvas panel. Then, add an image and set its anchor to full. Reset the offset values to 0 and add your background image for the main menu. Now, from the palette tab, add a vertical box and set its anchor to full. Change the offsets left and right to 800, offset top to 600, and offset bottom to 50. Drag and drop a button from the palette tab into the vertical box. In the details tab, set its size to fill. Name this button start underscore btn. Duplicate this button 3 more times and name them options underscore btn, credits underscore btn, and exit underscore btn. To create some spacing between the buttons, add spacer widgets from the palette tab between start underscore btn and options underscore btn. Adjust the padding value as needed. Duplicate the spacer and place it between options underscore btn and credits underscore btn. Repeat this process to create spacing between credits underscore btn and exit underscore btn. Now, from palette tab, add text widgets inside each button and change their text values to start, options, credits, and exit. Select all the text widgets in the hierarchy and change their font size to 30. Select start underscore btn, then in the details tab, select appearance and style. Expand the normal, hovered, and pressed sections. In the content browser, pick the button image you want from the main menu assets. If you're using the provided assets, select the image ending with n. Now, in main menu underscore UI, use this image in the normal and hover sections of the style by clicking the arrow next to the image. Select the image ending with P for the button in the content browser. In the main menu, go to the pressed section and use the selected image. Lastly, change draw as from rounded box to image in all sections, including normal, hovered, and pressed, to avoid a border around your button. Now, right-click on the Style section, select Copy, and paste it into the Style section of the other buttons. Compile and save. Open the main menu level. Open the level blueprint. In the event graph, near Event Begin Play, add a Get Player Controller node. From this, add Set Input Mode UI Only node. Again, from the Get Player Controller node, add a Set Show Mouse Cursor node. Check the box and connect the execution pin. Now, from the execution pin, add a Create Widget node and choose Main Menu Underscore UI from the dropdown. Finally, from the return value, add an Add to Viewport node. Compile and save. Now, go to the level. Before you press play, go to the world settings and change the game mode to game mode. Then, press play. Occasionally, in the editor viewport, the main menu may appear squeezed, so it's recommended to play in a new window. You'll see the main menu on your screen. Before we add the loading screen, if you're enjoying this video so far, please consider subscribing to my channel for more videos. In main menu underscore UI, select the start underscore BTN and scroll down to the events section in the details tab. Create an on-clicked event. In the graph, from on-clicked, add open level by object reference and choose loading underscore MM2GM from the dropdown. Now, select the exit underscore BTN in the designer and create an on-clicked event. In the graph, from on-clicked exit underscore BTN, add execute console command and type exit in lowercase. Compile and save. Now, in the maps folder, open any loading level and in the world settings, set the game mode to game mode. Do the same for another loading level. Save the levels, and in the HUD folder, create a new widget blueprint named Loading Screen Underscore UI. Open it, and from the Palette tab, add a Canvas panel. Add an image and set its anchor to full, with all offset values set to 0. Now, set your background image from the content browser. Then, add a progress bar and set its anchor to the center. Adjust the position X to -475 and position Y to 375. Change the size X to 920 and size Y to 22. In the Details tab, select Style and expand the section. Go to the UI folder in the Content browser and select the progress bar background image. In the Loading Screen underscore UI, set this image as the background image for the progress bar. Now, in the UI folder, select the progress bar line image and use it as the fill image for the progress bar. Check if it's working by changing the percent value in the Details tab. Now, go to the event graph and create a new variable called progress value with the type set to float. From the event tick and delta time pin, add a multiply node with the secondary value set to 0.2. From the return value of the multiply node, add an addition node. Change the pin from primary to secondary by holding Ctrl. Then, from the primary pin of the addition node, add a get progress value. From the return value of the addition node, add a clamp float and set the max value to 1. Finally, from event tick, add set progress value and connect the return value of the clamp node to the progress value pin. Compile and save. In the designer, select the progress bar, and in the details tab, beside the percent, select bind and choose the progress value variable we created. Compile and save. Now, go to the level. Make sure you have loading underscore mm to gm opened and open the level blueprint. Near event begin play, add get player controller. From it, add set input mode UI only and connect the execution pins. Add create widget and select loading screen underscore UI from the dropdown. From the return value, add an add to viewport node. Then, add a delay node with a duration of 6 seconds. From the completed pin, add open level by object reference. If you are using custom characters and follow the character selection tutorial, choose CS underscore map from the dropdown. If you have just one character, choose runner underscore map. Compile and save. Now, select all the nodes from this blueprint, copy them. Now, open loading underscore GM to MM level, then open the level blueprint and paste the copied nodes. In the open level by object reference, change the level to main menu. Compile and save. Now, go to the HUD folder and open game over underscore UI. Select the exit text and change it to main menu. Also, change the button name. Open main menu underscore UI, select any button, and copy the style section. Go back to game over underscore UI, select the buttons, right-click on the style section, and paste it. Now, go to the event graph. Delete the execute console command that connects to on-click exit BTN, and add open level by object reference. From the drop-down, choose loading underscore GM to MM level. Compile and save. Open the project settings, then maps and modes. Change the game default map to main menu. Go to main menu underscore UI, from the palette tab, add an image onto the canvas panel. Set the anchor to the top left corner and change the position X to 25 and position Y to 50. Also, change the size X and Y to 100. Name the image highscore underscore IMG and duplicate it, naming the duplicate coins underscore IMG. Change the position X to 25 and position Y to 175. From the textures folder, select the rank icon, and in the main menu underscore UI, select the highscore underscore IMG. In the details tab, press the arrow beside the image. Do the same for the coin icon. From the palette tab, add text and anchor it to the top left corner. Change the position X to 125 and position Y to 75. Duplicate the text and set the position X to 125 and position Y to 200. Select the text next to the high score icon and create a binding. Go to the HUD folder and open gameplay underscore UI. In the event graph, open the high score text function and copy all the nodes. Now, go back to main menu underscore UI and rename the getText function to getHighScoreText and paste the nodes we copied. Do the same for the coins text, create a new binding for the coins text and rename the binding to getCoinText. Now, go to gameplay underscore UI, open getCoinText function, copy the nodes, go back to main menu underscore UI, and paste the nodes in getCoinText function and connect the nodes. Compile and save. In the designer, select the two text widgets and change their font to Roboto Lite and font size to 30. Compile and save. Now, open the main menu level and press play. You will see that everything looks good. When you press start, you will also get a loading screen, and then CS underscore map is opened. Now you can select your character and press play. When the character dies, you can return to the main menu to change your character or quit the game. You will also notice that the coins are updated in the main menu. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.